Mitchell. The one jump ball to start the basketball game. If there is another one, that would be to start an overtime. There's some disagreement around the country over whether they like the rule or not. It was principally put in because coaches felt that with the great size of players today, that the officials simply couldn't throw the ball in straight is what it came down to. There's Joe B. Hall with the Kentucky Wildcats. He sends them away. Chuck Verderber, number 34, surprise starter at the forward. Gary Cord and Verderber will be at the forward. We had expected Charles Hurt. Verderber been out of action during workouts with a bad back, and there might be a little conditioning problem there, Larry. He missed 5 days recently.
Fred, in visiting with the University of Kentucky basketball staff yesterday, there are several things they're looking for. They want some keys tonight. They want to find out what direction, what's the benchmark for this club this year. Turbin, obviously, a big question. They need to know about Master and Minifield, as we said at the top of the show, but they've got to get some leadership from Verderber.
Sam Bulley may be back in December. Turbin at the center. Stijic, a seven-footer, controls the pit for Yugoslavia. Dmitrovic up on the near side to Vilfan. Vilfan to Stijic at the high post. Elvin Turpin out covering. Kentucky man-to-man. Stijic almost turned it over. Gets the ball to Vilfan. Ivar Vilfan, one of the veterans of Olympic action for this club. We mentioned they're the 1980 Olympic champions. Only three members of that team are here tonight. Vilfan pops from the top of the circle, and now Turpin controls the rebound. And up comes Kentucky. In a field, Derek Gord tries it in a hurry, too strong. Turpin won the rebound battle, but walked with the basketball.
Good effort that time by Melvin Turpin. He went in strong to the board. That's a good indication. If he can do that on the backboard consistently this year, Kentucky will have a good basketball year.
Only one thing belongs to the Yugoslavs here tonight, age and experience. Dalapagic is 30 years old. Jesus, 27. Petrovic is a young player at 17. New member of the club. We have a foul down court. It goes against Yugoslavia. That is against Ivo Sinara.
Sinara got a little bit of an elbow into Horde down the line, and the official, Hank Nichols, got it.
Yugoslavia, a very big basketball team. They have four players, 6'10 and over. They have a lot of experience. Master. Yugoslavia man-to-man. In a field.
Set up a little stack offense down inside. Trying to keep their big people down there and operate outside with Master and Minifield. Here's Master.
A little bit too strong with the try. Yugoslavia the rebound. Sinara off immediately to Vilfan. Vilfan's been bothered by an injured ankle, but he's in the starting lineup tonight. This is their good player. Dalapagic at the baseline. And we have a whistle blowing and a foul against Chuck Verderber of the University of Kentucky. The team fouls are even at one apiece.
Dalapagic, 30 years of age, experience, took care of himself there, Fred. He protected the basketball through the foul from Verderber.
Dalapagic is averaged 26 points a game the last three games on this tour. Yugoslavia 2-2. Down the line, and a foul called as Vilfan made the drive. He was fouled by Derry Cord, first on Horde, second on the University of Kentucky.
We're seeing the end of a great play right there. Sinara made a great pass inside the Vilfan. Sinara really made the play when Vilfan went back door. He simply beat Minifield.
Vilfan, 23 years old. He's a 6'4 guard. He had played in 64 international games coming to this ballgame. He's now 6-for-7 at the free throw line his last three games. That one's in and out. Rebound. Yugoslavia. Zizic back up. Misses. Horde had it. Zizic gets it back. Johnny Walk, the shot knocked away by Turpin. Here comes Minifield, running the break. Master off the baseline.
That's what they like to do, Fred. Get the ball to Minifield on the break. He controls it down the middle. The lanes were filled by Master and Horde, left and right. He got the ball to Master. Master got the basket.
Sinara, here's the lane. Dalapagic misses. Horde with a rebound. 2-2 ball game. 2-1 ball game. There is Salapazzi tipping. Rebound up. Vilfan and a charging foul called against Vilfan. His first, the second foul on Yugoslavia in the ballgame. Here it is again.
You'll see good position by Derek Horton right there. Here comes the play. He misses the ball. Vilfan goes back up, the shoulder into Horton's chest. A little bit of acting. Horton got the Academy Award. He also threw the foul.
Number 10, Dirk Minifield with the basketball. Gilby Hall says might be the best guard in the country, but he just turned it over, and here comes Salapazzi to Vilfan, and he stuffed it. Vilfan has 3 points for Yugoslavia, and we have a 5-5 tie with 17:07 left in the first half. Again, the first of over 90 college basketball games you'll see on ESPN this year. Quite a schedule coming your way this winter. Starts with a doubleheader Saturday. Kansas and North Carolina, Pittsburgh and Alabama, Birmingham. Live on ESPN. Jump shot. Alvin Turpin, good.
And again, off a rebound. Turpin inside to get the basketball, and that's what Kentucky has to have against a strong Yugoslavian team.
Well, you feel like the tempo is kind of up for grabs a little bit?
Well, they're both a little tentative right now. You kind of feel each other out a little bit in the first couple of minutes.
I think his pass was deflected. It was intended for Vilfan. Tipped out of bounds. Belongs to Yugoslavia. And the 17-year-old, Dragan Petrovic, will play it in right in front of him. And we have the foul called on Dirk Minifield on the inbound pass.
Minifield trying to fight over that Sonara pick right there. And he's trying to get around it. Vilfan kind of squeezed him off, and he grabbed Vilfan trying to get over the screen.
Petrovic again looking to play it in. Does the Sonara, very cord with him. Again, Kentucky man-to-man, both clubs are. Sonara off the side of the circle. Short with a try, and Turpin claims the rebound to Minifield. He tried to set the trap. Salapazzi did, but Minifield slid by it. Now he's fouled.
This one's Field. No, it was Petrovic again.
Petrovic got him. The first foul on Petrovic. Dragan Petrovic, a 6'6", 17-year-old player. And here's the
ability of Minifield. Look at his athletic ability. Good move to the left. Started. There he is. Grabbed right there. He's quick, Chris.
Ball out of bounds belongs to Yugoslavia, and they were thinking international rules right there, Larry.
There's a rule change from the European type of basketball to the United States type. In the United States, you have to hand the basketball to the official, who in turn gives it to the player out of bounds. In European play, they grab the basketball and run with it.
Salapazzi pushed on the far side, feeds down low, feeds it, turns to Cook. No good, tipped out by Turpin, taken by Minifield. 7-5 Kentucky, and here come the Wildcats. Master down low, wants to kick it out, and does to Minifield. Had a shot, passed it up. Lord.
That's what Kentucky lacked last year, was good outside shooting. It looks like Master, Horton, and Minifield want to pick up that outside shooting role this year.
9-5 Kentucky, 15-36 left in the first half. Salapazzi, long the circle. Can't get rid of Verderber, fires the off-balance jumper, and Turpin claims the rebound. Salapagic, the veteran on the Yugo team, he has played in 188 international games. Verderber has it, jump hook, and out, rebound, Jesus for Yugoslavia, and a foul call against the University of Kentucky. Glenn Wirst, the official, signaling the foul on Chuck Verderber. First on Verderber.
Here's a flurry of action underneath. You'll see the shot short, bounces across on the other side of the rim. Good rebound by Turpin that time. Goes down for a strong move. Should have never brought the ball down. That gives the opportunity to the defense. He misses the jump hook. Here's the rebound on the other side by Zizic and the foul by Verderber.
Petrovic in trouble, clears at the field side. Good drive by Salapazzi. He has two, and it's a 9-7 ball game. Kentucky with a 2-point lead in the basketball. Minifield has some penetration, and the foul called against Vilfan, his second personal foul, the fourth on Yugoslav. We have a timeout here with 14:53 left in the first half. The score, Kentucky 9, Yugoslavia 7. In Rupp Arena, Jim Master, Derek Horde for Kentucky. In the Wildcats by by Vielfaut. He has 4 points. He's 2 for 3 at the line. Substitution. Nicky Beal is going to replace Kurt Minifield as the guard for Kentucky. Minifield, the 6'3 junior, sits down. Beal, a 5'11 sophomore, coming to Kentucky in the ballgame. Vielfaut good again. He's 3 for 4 at the line, has 5 points, and we're tied at 9 with 14:25 left in the first half. Reputation on field is very, very quick. Not a very good shooter, good passer, good defense. Master couldn't find the shot, and a foul called against Petrovic. Dragan Petrovic, 17-year-old guard, picks up his second personal foul. There you see the Yugoslav coach, Bogdan Hanjevic, unhappy with the officiating. Now he's talking to his players.
I wonder if he can communicate with his American officials. You know, the first thing he told me when I saw him at the hotel today, asking how it's been going on the tour?
Officiating, sir.
Okay, the world over.
Derek Hoard knocks down the jumper off the side of the circle. He has 4 points, 11-9. Sorry, that never changes from country to country. That's the first thing they all say. They also say that having to play NCAA rules, person, it works the other way when the American colleges have to play the international rules. Petrovic, Jezic, in the lane, tried to hook, couldn't get it. Intercepted by Beal, and he steps out of bounds with the basketball. Good hustle. He just couldn't quite control it. Good defense by Kentucky that time.
Very well defensively. Nicky Beal again. His reputation, very quick, good defense. Let's keep an eye on him and see what he can do coming in here replacing Minifield.
Collin Hodges.
Here we go.
Charles Hurt in the ballgame draws the personal foul. Hurt, the 6'6 junior from Shelbyville, Kentucky, picks up the first foul.
Let's watch Alapazi take the shot again. You'll see Charles Hurt come in. Watch him go right up in Hurt's face. He'll go up to draw the foul, actually lean into Hurt a little bit. Both guys trying to go straight up, but Alapazi draws the foul because he's the offensive player.
Alapazi, the 6'7, 30-year-old Yugoslavia, has 3 points.
Oh, good tip.
Good tip by Žižić, the 7-footer. It's 12-11. Yugoslavia has their first lead of the ballgame with 13:25 left in the first half. Beal against Vielfaut. Can't get the shot. Turpin along the lane. Doesn't get it. The tip good by Derek Hoard. Oh, and with he in the air, he has a half dozen points.
Good rebound by Hoard this time. He looks like he's playing a little bit looser this year than he did last year. The last first 2 years he's been here, he's been a little bit tentative.
Vigic so good, the ball on the floor, pile up and a jump ball. And the ball will be out of bounds to the University of Kentucky. The possession belongs to Kentucky with the no jump ball rule. They're playing in the NCAA this year. Again, there'll be one jump ball to start the game. And then they alternate, taking it out of bounds from there.
And if the next jump ball opportunity goes to the Yugoslavia next.
That's right. If there is another jump ball, it would be to start an overtime period. And that can be a factor late in the ball game. Nicky Beal, baseline. Turpin lost it, picks it up, tried to shoot, gets to Master. Master can't shoot, gets to Hurt, he can, and he hits. Well, Hurt has two.
Good ball movement that time, Frank. Kentucky had a chance to take two bad shots that time, and they passed them both up to make good passes. They got the good shot from Hurt.
They're facing a lot of size in this Yugoslav team. They're shutting down a lot of shot opportunities. Petrovic has it blocked by Master, and he's fouled from behind by Sinara. Second foul on Sinara. Jim Master blocked the shot. He's a 6'4 sophomore from Fort Wayne. And that'll put Jim Master on the free throw line. Master averaged 7 points a game last year, Larry, but that's not really accurate. You're looking at the Yugoslav coach there, the fellow with the mustache. Because Master played so well late in the year.
Well, the Kentucky staff really is pleased with his progress. You know, he was a freshman last year. And that 1 year of emotional maturity that you get from that freshman to sophomore year as we see Master make his shot is so vitally important to a young man like him. He's coming in here, and he's going to have to assume a leadership role as a sophomore guard out here. And he's very capable of doing it. He looks a lot better this year than he did last year.
Ryan, do you have anyone?
Yeah, he does. The guy plays at Phoenix right now.
My name's Kyle Macy. He was a pretty good guard here at the University of Kentucky. Pass deflected by Beal. Picked up Master. He's got a man under, and Derek Hoard has it. Derek Hoard knocks it down at the end. Hoard has 8. Kentucky up by 7 points. And the Wildcats have hit Yugoslavia with a burst here with 12:05 left in the first half. Sinara, we might have goaltending. It is. Goaltending against Turpin gives Sinara 2 points. Sinara, 6'10", had the shot blocked from behind, but they call goaltending against 6-11 Velvet Serpents. And we have a timeout called here with 12:01 left in the first half. And Kentucky, having hit Yugoslavia with the burst, has gone in front here by 7. Ball comes together on the coaches again. 12:01 left in the first half. Our score, Kentucky 19, Yugoslavia 12. Again, 19-12 Kentucky. Larry Conley?
That's the end of the play right there before the timeout. Master to Hort. It was a good defensive play. Beal, Master, and Hort converging on the Yugoslavian national team's guards. They got the layup, then the immediate timeout by the national team.
And Dalapagic charged with a foul, his first, so Derek Hort will be on the free throw line looking for his 9 points. Larry, we've seen 8 minutes. Any quick assessments of the early part of this game?
Well, I think a couple of things. One is that the Yugoslavian team, having played four nights in a row, they look a little weary to me, Fred. I think they're a little leg weary. But for the same token, when Kentucky made that run at them, they came right back down and got a basket. Zizek got it inside. But Kentucky, on the other hand, very, very deep. They've got a lot of players. They can go to a lot of people and probably will play a lot of people tonight to try to answer some questions they may have about their play.
Foul occurred after the shot. Dalapagic picking up his foul. And Orr with both free throws now has 10 points. And Kentucky leads 21-12.
They went to a 1-3-1 zone, just got a turnover, and it'll be Kentucky's basketball.
Charles Hurd deflected inside. The ball belongs to Kentucky, and the Wildcats trying to establish some control of this game. Yugoslavia about to go to the bench. Derek Hord works against Dalapagic. This is the shot. Has the rebound, and he's got it. Derek Hord with a dozen.
Good comeback. He went right around four guys that time. Two of his players, two of the Yugoslavians, got the rebound and put it back.
And Derek Hord pacing Kentucky here with 11:27 left in the first half. Kentucky up by 11. Sonara, Dalapagic off the baseline. Hurt bothers the shot, and Kirkman has the rebound. Minifield, pressure on in the circle. He's got Hurt. Shot good. And Kentucky taking Yugoslavia apart here.
Fred, that play was made by Dirk Minifield with the pressure he put on that defense. When he took the ball deep inside like that, they committed to him. He got the ball to the open man, and Hurt got the best.
Jesus. This is the hook shot and a foul called against Turpin. It's the first on Turpin. Number six on Kentucky. Yugoslavia has been whistled for 7 fouls. There's a look. And Leodron Moric about to come into the ball game for Yugoslavia. Timeout taken here with 11:01 left in the first half. Here's the play.
Here's Zizi down inside. He turns, makes a good pivot move right across the lane. Good long step. Good fundamentals there, Fred. Good long straight arm hook shot.
There's your score. 11:01 left in the first half. Kentucky up by 13 over Yugoslavia. We'll be right back. International basketball from Lexington, Kentucky right now on ESPN. Live Saturday, December 5th, 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 6 o'clock Pacific. ESPN takes you to the Bantamweight Championship. Gustavo Balas, Rafael Pedrosa, number one ranked contender from Panama. Back to basketball. Rupp Arena, Lexington, Kentucky. Sorry, Kentucky up by 13. They've hit Yugoslavia with a heck of a burst here.
And they haven't done it with great offensive ability. I think they've done it with a lot of defense. They've gotten some steals at midcourt. They've gotten good fast breaks. Most of the baskets they've gotten in the last 3 to 4 minutes have been layups, and that's a sign of good defense.
Quickness paying dividends.
Well, I tell you what, you know, when the change is made there with Hurd in and Verderber out, Verderber gives them a lot of muscle, but Hurd gives them an awful lot of quickness.
The 7-footer, Ryko Zizek, just got an air ball. Boy, is he a veteran. 133 international games under his belt. Member of the Olympic Championship squad. Zizek comes back, hits the second free throw. Substitution now, Zizek sits down. And in comes 6'11", Miedrog Maric, a 24-year-old. He was also on the Olympic team. So a change of center for Yugoslavia. 25-13, Kentucky, 10-55, less than the first half. Minifield to Lopez. Technical foul call. I think Turpin grabbed the rim. And he probably thinks it was worth it. Joby Hall doesn't like the call. Here it is.
Here's Minifield. He turns. He looks. Makes a good pivot with the right to get open. Turpin gets a good screen. Works around it. Here's the jam. And there's the grab.
23,000 Kentucky fans are booing the officials for the call, but it's a good one. There's Joby Hall. He's not happy with it. He wants to talk to the official. Now the budget for the free throw is good. Oh, what an exciting play. Larry, in many years in college basketball, you couldn't dunk. Some people still don't like it. I'll tell you what, it can electrify a crowd. It can ignite a team and do a lot of things for
you. And, you know, it's interesting, too, in the construction of the new basketball backboards and rims. They have those rims now that will pull off so that there will be no more shattering. I like Chocolate Thunder and people like that who shatter back.
Dimitrovic. Excuse me, Popovic to the basketball. Great save, but Kentucky has it. 3-on-1 against Popovic and Master. Good.
And again, Fred, it was defense. They got the steal. Good hands out front. They got the short 10-foot jumper.
Kentucky pressuring Yugoslavia here. They had the big guy bringing it up. Turpin got him in midcourt. And now Dolapadzic with the basketball. In the middle, taken away by Turpin. He overthrew his man, Maric, and Turpin has it to Minifield. Kentucky by 15. Down low, Hurd shovels the Horde. Good.
Nice pass. Charles Hurd to Jerry Court. Right across the lane. He got it up and got it in.
17-point lead for Kentucky with 10:03 left in the first half.
Fred, Kilby Hall's got to be awfully pleased with the way his defense is playing right now. They really have done it well. Great job. We got a foul.
We have a foul on the lane, I believe, against Melvin Turpin. Or maybe Charles Hurd. Jerry Curd will sit out. The foul was called against Charles Hurd, his second personal foul. It will put Nidrog Lavich, the 24-year-old 6'11 center, on the free throw line. It's good.
Lavich to the free throw. Getting back to the Kentucky game and the way they're playing. He's got to be awfully heartened to Joe Hall and the Kentucky contingency. And very happy with the way their defense is playing. They've done a super job so far.
Reached 2-for-2 at the free throw line. It's now 31-16 Kentucky. And off the bench for Yugoslavia, that's Vienko Savovic. Sitting down is Dolapadzic. With some blows, foul on the lane. This one's called against Savovic, the man who just came off the bench. His first personal foul.
You want to see the speed, quickness of Minifield? Watch it. He went right by that man. He just gets through three people right there and draws the foul, and it was Savovic that got him.
Kurt Minifield last year led Kentucky in free throw shooting, an 89% shootover. It's his first one tonight, the 6'3 junior from Lexington, Kentucky, Kilby Hall. 10th year, Lexington, Kilby Hall. This year, Kurt Minifield is 2-for-2 at the line, first 2 points tonight. First, you think about Minifield last year. He had 71 turnovers all year.
He handles the ball extremely well. He's the guy that, when they are getting pressed, he gets the basketball. He's responsible for bringing it up.
Reach. Reach to get rid of it. Out front. Reach. They turn it over. Kentucky has the basketball.
I really think quickness is making the Kentucky game right now. It's obvious to me that they've got some quickness. They're going to show it this year. If they can maintain this type of level of basketball, they're very, very tough tonight. Defensively, they're getting a lot of turnovers, good hands, quickness, good shooting.
11 points for Jim Masters. Well, I know you watched him shoot in practice yesterday.
I saw them run offensive patterns. I never saw a shot inside 22 feet by him, and he gets 7 out of 10.
Fun shooting. This is Durich for the basketball. Almost knocked loose by Minifield. Durich picks it up again.
Kentucky's back in that 1-3-1 zone defense.
Ball popping is good. Petrovic got it. First 2 points for Dragan Petrovic. 35-18, Kentucky. Wildcats with 8:47 left in the first half has really opened this ball game up. Master pulls up. Hey! 15 points for Jim Master. Tough to defend that.
You can tell this crowd loves this because they wanted to see him succeed and do well this year.
Yeah,
this is any indication, it's going to be a good year for him.
Well, this Kentucky club is still a young club. Started one sinker tonight. John Paul. The ball belongs to Yugoslavia. Kentucky tonight started Jerry Cord, a junior. Hurt did not start. He's a junior. He replaced Verderber, the only senior that started. Turpin, a sophomore. Minifield, a junior. Master, a sophomore.
Watch Minifield come flying from the baseline. Well, it was a little bit later. He was earlier on that play. The pass came inside, and there's the jump ball right there.
Popovic for the basketball, Yugoslavia. Kentucky in the zone again. Maric just hands it off. Maric lobs, knocked loose by Master. Master and then Popovic on the drive. He got it in the foul. It's going to count. 50 points for Master, and he's on the free throw line. And Popovic fouled it.
You think Jim Master's having a good year? Look at this. Right now, he's having a great game. He gets the foul, and he gets the basket.
Jim Master will go to the line with
first basketball game. I wouldn't go out on a limb with the number of clubs in the country this year. There must be 20 to 25 good basketball teams out there this year.
Sorry, the last 2 years, the NCAA has been wide open. Any one of maybe 20 clubs could have won it. This year, maybe exactly the same, and I love it that way. Jim Master hunting number 16 on the line in Venus. So we have a whistle blowing. Somebody got in the lane too soon, and Master's going to get to shoot again. He's not going to miss often. 86% free throw shooter last year. He is from Fort Wayne, Indiana, from Paul Harris High School, just a sophomore. Really classy. A little bit of an unusual style there, Aiden.
A little bit like Mason. Mason,
yeah.
Same thing. Keeps the spin down a little bit. Not a bad one to copy.
Yugoslavia scored 18 points in 12 minutes in the first half of this game so far.
They're getting
having trouble getting anything going. Long jumper, no good. Tip try, won't count. Foul call against Sabovic, his second personal foul. Yugoslavia can't get in their offense.
But there are two things that are very apparent to me at this point right now. One is Kentucky's defense. It's extremely good, and it's very quick. And the second thing is, fundamentally, they're doing just about everything well. What's this screen out right there by Charles Hurt? See Hurt right there, how he screened it to Sabovic on the outside there. He got pushed to Sabovic, but he had good position. I tell you what, it's really important if you get your club started off on the right fundamentals at the beginning of the year, and obviously they have. They should have a pretty successful year.
Charles Hurt, 6'6 junior from Shelbyville, Kentucky, misses the free throw. With the rebound to Kentucky's Kirkland, jump shot good. Elvin Kirkland gets his 6 point, and Kentucky's up 42-18 with 7:39 left in the first half. And the Yugos are disorganized right now. Maurice with the basketball. Kirkland out covered.
Kentucky back into that man-to-man defense. But just look at the pressure. Keep an eye on the pressure. We get an upstairs view. McGerber almost got the steal there. What's the pressure they're exerting on every offensive player, denying the pass?
Reach might have walked with the ball. He did, and Yugoslavia turns it over again. I tell you what, Joby Hall's going to have trouble finding something to yell at him about at halftime here. This ball club playing extremely well. He has to be happy with it. Jelko Poljak, number 9, in the lineup now for Yugoslavia, and Reach is going to sit down. Poljak 6'10", Reach 6'11" out of the lineup, and here comes Minifield working against Reach. Master, great fake, floating jumper, not quite, but Turpin's there, and a foul call down in the lane against Yugoslavia.
Looks like Terrell Hurt was the one inside that got the rebound this time. He's going to go to the line. He was the person who got fouled. I tell you what, they've got great board strength inside when Hurt's there, because he probably is the strength of this club inside at that forward position. You know, it's going to be difficult for Bowie to come back and win his position if Turpin keeps on playing the way he's playing.
Different type players, aren't they?
They really are. You know, Bowie's got the real polish. He's a good shooter from 15 to 18 feet. And Turpin really is the raw kid. He's the one who's really working at improving his game.
Hurt misses. He's 0 for 2 at the free throw line. I'm sure there are going to be a lot of times this year when you'll see Turpin and Bowie in the lineup together. Another substitution for Yugoslavia. This time it's Radonovic coming off the bench. Sasha Radonovic, who's a 17-year-old, just 6'9". Chuck McGerber was whistled for his second foul at the other end of the floor. So Larry Bowie really likes to play a forward as much as he likes to play a center, doesn't he?
That would limit them somewhat in what they can do defensively, having both of those big guys in there. They basically would have to stay with some form of a zone, and with three pretty quick people to surround them. You got Master, you got Beal, you got Minifield, you've got Hoard, you've got Hurt. All five of those guys can surround those other two, but the two big guys inside, the two towers, you got to basically play a zone defense because they can't come out on the floor. And I know if I were an opposing coach, that's what I would do. I'd try to get them away from the bench.
Joby Hall, Kentucky coach, looking on. Entering his 10th year, his record, 205-66.
I'll say this, I know a lot of coaches in the country who are very, very pleased to have both of those guys inside and be more than willing to fight those problems.
That's right. Poljak gets the first free throw, a 22-year-old. A lot of international experience. That's three games under his belt coming into this tour. He's 6'10". 2 for 2 at the line. His first 2 points of the night. 7:06 left in the first half. 42-20 Kentucky. Minifield to Derek Hoard. Baseline to Hurt. Back to Hoard. Takes, goes by one man. Feeds it back to Hurt. Outside Master. 20. Too strong. Look at Hurt. Love Hurt. He's got a half dozen.
We're going to see that one again. That was great strength inside. He actually was underneath the basket. Came back to the outside, one hand skip above the rim.
44-20, Kentucky. 6:38 left in the first half. Down Peter Strong with a try. Tip try. Basket won't count. Foul called against Zizic. And that is personal foul number one on Rajko Zizic, the 7 foot center from Yugoslavia.
And again, what calls that foul was good blocking out. They screened off, didn't allow their man to get inside. As Bogdan Konjevic is looking at his club, he must be saying some things we don't understand, but I know he's upset with his club the way they're playing.
Curry in all the pre-Olympic predictions. Everyone thought that it was worthy tough for the American squad in Moscow and the Olympics. Unfortunately, we did not get to go because of the boycott. The boy looking at this game tonight, of course, they only have three players on that team. Maybe it's unfair. I would have sent our squad if we were going. I would have taken our chances with our squad, is what I'm trying to say.
The political turmoil at the time didn't dictate that we go.
That's right. Elvin Turpin misses the free throw try. Ball is out of bounds to Kentucky, and everything is going Kentucky's way right now. Minifield will play it in into the Kentucky basket with 6:34 left in the first half. Kentucky walloping the U.S.
You get the feeling you're sitting amongst 23,500 coaches here who are sort of evaluating their team just like Joe B. Hall is?
Yes, I do. I really do. Say, these Kentucky fans know their players, and they know the game. I'm going to see that last play again. Ball gets up on the board.
There's Ford. He committed the foul inside. He went up trying to get the basketball, but he couldn't get it from Zizic. Zizic is a good, strong rebound.
Second foul on Gary Ford. Been a lot of fouls in his first half. 6:27 left in the half. Kentucky leading 44-20. Gary, you started 3 years here. You're all Southeast Conference here. Won several awards here. Very consistent player. I'll tell you what, nobody in Kentucky has forgotten you yet. They remember their players here, too, don't they?
Yeah. Well, it's just tradition. It's steep, just good, rich tradition.
Ball on the floor, picked up by Yugoslavia. Petrovic goes baseline, gets it. He got a screen and he walks with the basketball. It goes right back to Kentucky. And I don't mean to be laughing at the Yugoslavs. It's just funny the way it happened.
Petrovic looked like he was on a pogo stick. He took one step and bounced two more.
I don't say anything about Kentucky fans. It's tradition. And a lot of class in this program. Program to be admired. They do it, and they do it well. Derek Ford missing the shot. Kentucky perhaps tiring a little bit here late in the first half. Petrovic moves it up. On the far side, the pass to Poliak, whistle blows, the ball goes right back to Kentucky, and both ball clubs may be tired.
5:54. Yeah, we've got 5:54 to play, and they've already got 44 points. If they keep this rate up, they're going to be somewhere in the mid-50s, maybe a high 50s.
Yugoslavia so far in this third defeated Illinois last night in Champaign, in fact, 71-66. They beat Rutgers 109-98. Foul called at the far end. Yugoslavia lost to Purdue 71-57. They lost to Indiana 73-65. Foul against Kentucky. Yugoslavia will go to the free throw line. Turpin drew his second personal foul.
Just watch it inside. You'll see Melvin Turpin trying to establish his position. He pushed off right there on number 7, Zizic. The ball will go. It looked like he may have come over his back, but I guess Turpin got him before he made his position move.
10 fouls have been called against Kentucky. A dozen against Yugoslavia. Zizic misses the free throw. Turpin held but grabbed the rebound. He was being held and he steered it with one hand, flat-footed. Minifield takes a move on Petrovic. Shot good. Dirk Minifield, first bucket. He has 4 points.
Gave him a little rabbit move right there. Fake one way, went left, got inside, and got a real short jumper. Good move, Dirk Minifield.
Jumper off the baseline, in and out. Rebound. Zizic has it, loses on the floor. Minifield moved by Petrovic. They have to beat Popovic at the other end. And oh, Dirk Minifield right over Popovic, and did he nail it? He is 6'3", and he went to the Raptors to drive it home. Kentucky up by 28.
Well, that was a great play by Dirk Minifield. Here's another steal.
Turpin steals the pass. They say it was on the end line, and the ball belongs to Yugoslavia. We're going to see the play at the other end again. Watch this.
I don't even believe this needs a comment. All you've got to do is just sit and watch. He comes down the floor, right in the middle of it, looks up, sees the defensive man go away from him. Watch this.
Hello. What an exciting play by Dirk Minifield. 48-20 Kentucky, 5:01 left in the first half. 23,000 fans in Rupp Arena, and the Wildcats are just singing them a song right now against a very good international basketball team. Petrovic deflected by Turpin out of bounds to Yugoslavia. The pass intended for Radonjic. Never got to it. Official Wentworth in front of us with the basketball. Petrovic, the 17-year-old, will play it in as you look at the Kentucky cheerleaders. And off the bench comes Tom Hite, the red shirt last year, 6'8 sophomore from Hamilton, Indiana. Melvin Turpin's going to get a breather. Hite at 6'8 replaces 6'11 sophomore Melvin Turpin. Rajan Dalapagic
looks like Yugoslavia is trying to attack it with a 1-3-1. They're sort of matching up. Radonjic racing down the lane, walks to the basketball. Kentucky has it back. With 4:45 left in the first half, Kentucky could take a 30-point lead here. They are up 48-20. Minifield brings it up slowly. Yugoslavia man-to-man. Kentucky just dissecting that defense. Master lobs inside the heights and he's fouled. That time Kentucky came down and set their offense up in a sort of a stack. You'll see both guys low on the block, two on each side. Here's the foul right here. Heights got it. He was over the back. Zizic got him over the back. But it was a good position move. Master moved to the baseline, got the ball, and he saw inside that time. Heights got him the basketball, and Heights got fouled.
You can bet this guy's happy to be on the floor. Redshirted last year. This year, they will redshirt Brett Barrett. Tom Heights will be playing. Heights gets the free throw. Has played in 16 countries. He knows something about international basketball. Coming out of high school, he played in a tour. 49-30 Kentucky with 4:30 left in the first half. Milipogic, hurt, no hurt. No hurt almost intercepted. Shot missed by Vilfan. Master grabs the rebound, fires it up to Hurt. The foul!
He's put on a clinic right now. I tell you, their defense is just outstanding.
Steal by Horde, and he's fouled as he got the ball up court to Master. Boy, Kentucky just owns this basketball game.
You know, the thing about it, Fred, is they came out of that man-to-man pressure that they put on the Yugoslavian national team. You get up by 30 points, and you really don't want to embarrass somebody. So you back off of it, and you sort of experiment with other things you're doing in practice. They've been working on a 1-3-1 trap. It's obviously going to work well for them this year if they've got this kind of equipment. Although, and I've got to say this, to maybe offset a little bit of what we're saying on the other side, I think Yugoslavia might be a little bit tired. They've played four straight games. They've been on airplanes, traveling. They're a pretty good basketball team. They've got three of their players from that Olympic team. But it still doesn't take away from the effectiveness that Kentucky has had both offensively and defensively so far in the first half.
Hurry, it's Thanksgiving vacation. I know a lot of college coaches are watching this ball game. I bet they're shuddering. They're looking at what Kentucky's getting done here in the next division game to start the season.
I tell you, Kentucky's December schedule is really tough, too. They've got some good ball games.
16 points now for Derek Horde. Yugoslavia with the basketball. Dalapagic working along the side. Fires up a wild jumper, misses. Zizic had a rebound, but he's over the back of Tom Heights. And a personal foul called, I think, against Kentucky. Against Tom Heights, it is. Heights draws the foul. There's Joby Hall, not quite believing the call, but he's up by 33 points and not overly concerned about it right now.
Let me back up and talk a little bit about that schedule that they've got lined up for this year. December the 5th, they play Ohio State in Columbus, which is never an easy task. Then they go across the state and play another, well, downstate, really, play another Big Ten rival, Indiana. Great ball game every year. Indiana, the present reigning NCAA champion. Then they've got Kansas and Lawrence, which you know a lot about. Good club, tough to beat in Lawrence. UKIT, and then they've got North Carolina and Notre Dame, and those are both clubs.
And then the Southeast Conference, which is not exactly Primrose Lane.
Well, that conference has really improved its basketball in recent years. It used to be Kentucky dominated it totally. But that's not true anymore. Alabama, Tennessee have come on so well, and LSU have recently.
Minifield, not quite. Heights is fouled as he tried to get it back up. So Heights will go to the free throw line.
I really would not like to say that this has turned into a laugher, but it's getting to be that way very, very quickly. We've still got 3:39 to go, and it's 53-22. Kentucky seems to be doing whatever they want to do at this moment. Minifield that time went by three players. Yugoslavia didn't even make an effort to get by to stop.
Vitar Vilfan drew his third personal foul. That puts Tom Heights on the free throw line. He's one for two, two for three. Here comes the freshman, Mike Ballinger, out of Jasper, Indiana, into the lineup now. 6'3 freshman, highly prized recruit. Jim Master is going to take a breather.
But they tell me this young man was a fine baseball player and football player at Jasper.
3-for-4 at the line now is Heights. Kentucky fans getting their first look here at Mike Ballinger. He'll find with the basketball. This is Jurich.
Good quickness by the Kentucky foul. They're moving it well.
Long jump shot by Juric, no good. Horde grabs the rebound, throws it away. Picked up by Vilfan for Yugoslavia to Sonara. Vilfan down the lane. Maric taken away. And
Kentucky having trouble with it. Horde got mugged. Nothing called. The ball's out of bounds to Yugoslavia. Joby Hall just found reason to be unhappy. He's talking to one of the officials, Henry Nichols, on the far side. He's not at all happy, and they're at it pretty good over there. Hall and Nichols jawing at one another. Yugoslavia has the ball.
What could you possibly be saying when you're 33 points ahead? One of your guys gets fouled. Obviously, it looked like he got fouled anyway.
Murray, Kentucky, in 47 years, has won 32 Southeast Conference titles, and a winning percentage, 8-17 Southeast Conference play.
Fred, they tell us, and we look at it in the book here, they've won over 1,267 games going back 77 seasons.
Well, the only other college, Kansas, perhaps number two. Minifield throws it up. I started to say they were number two. It seems like maybe somebody else.
North Carolina's
in there pretty good, yeah. Kentucky, the first college, to reach 1,000. 250 left in this first half. That foul, whistle against Minifield, his third personal foul. And Minifield now sits down. Nicky Beal back in the ball game with 245 left in the first half. Yugoslavia with the basketball. Kalapagic across court to pass. Juric in the lane. Shannara, the jump shot, no good. Rebound up and good that time. And that was Radonjić, one of the 17-year-olds, getting his first bucket of the night.
It's a good rebound that time by Radonjić. He got through three Kentucky players and got back up strong with the ball.
Ricky Beal, baseline, jump shot, Derrick Ford, good. He has 18 points in his first half, does Derrick Ford. 57-24 Kentucky. Yugoslavia just turned it over again. 2:08 left in the first half as Kentucky gets it back. In the lineup for Yugoslavia comes Petar Popovic. And sitting down will be Juric. So Juric will take a break. Kentucky with a 33-point lead. Vicky Beal brings it up court. Derrick Ford, Charles Hurt, Ballinger. Good feet in the middle to Heist. Had a foul call down underneath against Shannara. Tell you what, we haven't seen much of Mike Ballinger, but that was a pretty good-looking bounce pass. He just
sure was.
Entered into the key that time.
Foul on Shannara.
You know, you don't want to get this game out of perception, but it certainly can do an awful lot to the confidence of this Kentucky basketball team. As you mentioned earlier, being still fairly young, Fred, they don't have, well, they have two seniors basically on the club, and only one of them, Reserver, plays a lot. Most of the club is junior and sophomore oriented.
Bogdan Tanjevic, an unhappy man right now, the head coach of the Yugoslavs. Tom Heitz now has hit 5 out of 6 at the free throw line. Kentucky leads 59-24, 35-point goals for Kentucky, 1:49 left in the first half. Yugoslavia just looks shocked. Charles Hurt, Dickey Beal, across the lane to Heitz.
Dickey Beal ran across, didn't even look over. He just kind of flipped it, a good wrist pass. Chip Heitz grabbed it on the dead run and laid it in.
Look at that score. 1:30 left in the first half. Sing me a song, sweet music man. Kentucky's doing it now. Heitz knocked the ball loose. He's going to be called for a foul. Shannara holding his nose as Heitz walks away. 1:26 left in the first half.
Fouls away from the ball, it looks like.
Well, he's got number 51 on the board. Kentucky doesn't have a 51.
I think the foul was on Hurt, away from the basketball. He got Radonjić in the nose, he held him as he started to throw.
But it's number 5, Ballinger, his first foul is what they have on the board. Well, it's our first game. Up comes Kentucky, still up by 37. Beal, forced that shot. Rebound to Yugoslavia. Popovic picks it up. Lead pass up towards Shannara. Off on the far side, Beal found, and a foul call against Kentucky against Mike Ballinger, his second personal foul. Troy McKinley, another freshman, checks in for Kentucky. Derrick Ford's going to sit out. 18 points for Horde as he sits down.
I tell you, if Yugoslavia is in shock tonight, what do you think Illinois, Rutgers, Indiana, and Purdue are going to think tomorrow when they see the score?
Amazing. Beal found. Now 4 out of 5 to the line with a half dozen points. A 23-year-old, 6'4 guard for the Yugoslavs. It's the second free throw. But Kentucky's still down by 35 points. 1:10 left in the first half. I'll bet Joe Hall's going to be happy to see halftime. His ball club has lost its snap. They still have the big lead.
I wonder if Yugoslavia has simply quit on the thing. Foul call down the lane. It's been sloppy. And that one whistled against Yugoslavia's Sasha Radanovic. His first personal foul.
What's happening is Yugoslavia just almost giving up the inside position. Kentucky, who fights very, very hard to get position down low because they're such a strong club inside, is getting that position. They're getting the ball inside, and there are a lot of fouls that Yugoslavia are committing.
I'm going to say something. It does sound like a slap at European teams, but it isn't. But you've seen them before. I've seen them before. I've seen them give up when they get down in ball games before. Just simply quit on it. One reason maybe they play almost every night on this tour, and they may be thinking, well, we'll get them tomorrow. They go to Iowa to play. 63-26 Kentucky. Sonara misses. Look at her. He hadn't quit yet. He's high to grab the rebound. Looking for help gets Dickie Beal with 45 seconds left in the half. Joe Hall has his two freshmen in the game. There's one of them, Ballinger, with a basketball. Fires from 20. Too strong. Might have been a palming the ball call there, but it was passed up if it was. Bealfon misses. Dickie Beal, 26 seconds left now. Oh, what a move. Dickie Beal up court to Heights. The shot no good. And the rebound to Popovich. Lead pass up court. Radanovic got it. 4 points for Sasha Radanovic. 63-28 Kentucky.
See that move Beal made at midcourt to get around that defensive player?
That's an athlete.
Radanovic looked like he was nailed to the floor.
Ballinger, good feed to Heights for the two. Just about the time the gun goes off. Heights off the bench has 9 points in the first half. There's the end of the first half. The shot no good. And our halftime score at Rupp Arena, Lexington, Kentucky, it has belonged to the Wildcats. At halftime, Kentucky 65, Yugoslavia 28. Lexington, Kentucky, we're at halftime, and maybe these 23,000 Kentucky Wildcat fans are as stunned as we are and as stunned as the Yugoslavs are. Our halftime score, unbelievable. Kentucky 65, Yugoslavia 28. Fred White along with Larry Conley. Happy to have you along on ESPN. And Larry, I'm going to repeat what you said during the commercial because I really think you're right. You said that the game is out of kilter. Kentucky can't be this good. Yugoslavia can't be that bad. Boy, Kentucky's pretty good, and they've got a 37-point lead at halftime.
Well, they're definitely good. I'm not going to question that at all, and I think they're definitely a top-10 club. But if you have to look at the first half, let's look at the way they played. Obviously, the most outstanding feature in the first half of Kentucky was their defense, both their man-to-man defense, which exerted great pressure on Yugoslavia, and also their zone defense was very, very good. They trapped well. They got to the corners. They positioned themselves well to intercept the passes in the passing lane. But also, on the other hand, you've got to look at Yugoslavia. I think they played with a rather ambivalent attitude the first half. They seemed to, after they got down 20 points, they said, you're a great basketball team. We really don't want to come out and play you because we got four or five more games this week. Let your fans enjoy yourself. And I'll tell you, there are 23,000 people here who are enjoying it. I should make improvements, Jim. If you're on the other side, Tonjevich obviously has got a lot to talk about. You know, I just think his club is mental.
That's Larry Conley, brilliant shooting by Kentucky.
24 of 43 for 55.8%. But again, those were high percentage shots that they got from their defense, layups mostly. Free throws, 17 of 22 for 70%, which is not bad. The key at the bottom there, Fred, really is the turnovers. You can see
Yugoslavia has turned over 18 times to Kentucky's 8. They haven't hit a lick from the field. 25%, 7 out of 28. It is 14 out of 20 free throws. And Kentucky's quickness in defense is getting them really a lot of good shots. For Kentucky scoring, Master and Hort each have 16 points. Minifield with 6. Turpin has 8. Hurt has 10.
Heights off the bench with 9.
Well, Heights came off the bench late to pick up his 9. So, scoring really well balanced for Kentucky. They missed a Rupp Arena one-half record by a point. They had scored 66 against West Texas in this arena earlier. They got 65 in the first half here tonight. Kentucky cheerleaders smiling with very good reason. They have seen a brilliant first half of basketball. And Larry Conley, you look at the Kentucky Wildcats gathering around Kilby Hall. Larry, one more stat that we didn't mention when we reviewed them at halftime, and it's another reason Kentucky's ahead by so many.
And it's obvious. You know, Melvin Turpin had 11 rebounds at the end of the first half. There are teams that get 11 rebounds. He had 11 by himself. Most of them, obviously, on Yugoslavia's offensive end, because there wasn't a whole lot to grab on Kentucky's end.
Kentucky out-rebounded Yugoslavia 26-16, and they really did it with positioning and jumping, because the Yugos are really much bigger than this Kentucky ball club, with the exception of Melvin Turpin, but they started a seven-footer, 6'7", and 6'10 up front.
What do you think Joey Hall said to his club at halftime?
fellas, we aren't this good. We've got a lot of work to do. Go out and have fun. Tell you more about it later.
It's a good point. And here's a new rule coming into play, Fred.
Kentucky will have the ball inbound at the start of the second half. Again, new NCAA rule. One jump to start the game, and the teams alternate taking it out of bounds in jump ball situations. Jim Master comes off the pick, and it just about. Now it is taken away. Looks right back to Kentucky. Popovich had it for a moment. There's been a field. He misses. Masters there. Bates gets it up, and he's fouled. Foul called against Ryko Zizic, and he has three.
We probably can't run this back far enough, but Melvin Turpin made an excellent defensive play that time. He's the one who swatted the ball loose and got it to Master. Master got it to Minifield. Minifield back to Master on the baseline, and he drew the foul inside. Again, good defense by Kentucky. Good, quick hands.
Master's free throw, good. He's 5 for 5 at the free throw line. Now and has 17 points. Larry, the no jump ball rule is going to create some controversy around the country. I saw it the last couple of years in two conferences. And I have mixed feelings about it. I don't like it at the end of the game because you can make a great defensive play and force a jump ball, but the other team could still get the ball out of bounds and then be forced to make two outstanding defensive plays in order to get a shot at the ball.
Well, you're right. You're absolutely correct about that situation, except that here we are. The rules are made by the coaches themselves. I mean, they're the ones who vote them in. And if what they want is this type of rule, then give it to them. Let them play with it.
They simply don't think officials can throw it up straight with all the big men in the game, and that's why they went to this rule. I know a lot of coaches like it. A lot of coaches who know a lot more about it than I do like it.
Here's Minifield committing the foul right there. He got Petrovic as Petrovic went up to shoot the shot.
That is personal foul number 4 on Dirk Minifield, but it's not really a problem for Kentucky because they lead 67-28. Free throw good by Petar Popovich. He now has 3 points in the contest. And Kentucky gets the basketball back as Popovich gets his 4th point. Mickey Beal in the ball game now. Place Minifield, the ball out of bounds to Kentucky. The crowd's very quiet here. They're sold out, 23,000. But I think Kentucky shocked even their fans here so far in this game.
If what they wanted to do was make a favorable impression on their fans, I think they've done that tonight. And certainly won't sell any more tickets because they've already sold the place out for all year anyway.
Derek Hoare just getting the shot down for his 18th point as he's fouled as he gets it away. 69-30, Kentucky by 39.
Fred, an interesting aspect of this game right now for Joe B. Hall may be him checking out the discipline of his players. I mean, if you're a player on the court right now and you're leading by 40 to 50 points, what is your discipline like? Do you give up and just go ahead and play a sloppy game, or do you continue with the same type of basketball game that you've been taught the years you've been here?
Late pass to Vilfan, the shot no good, and Zizic coming up court, tips it in behind him. 9 points for Ryko Zizic. 70-32, Kentucky. 19 minutes left in this contest. Derek Hoare off a pick from Turpin. Jumper good. Basket count. Foul call against Dalapaci.
Kentucky can do no wrong tonight. You're going to see a great shot right here by Derek Hoare. Maybe a shot that should never have been taken except it went in. Watch him get bumped right there. Almost gets his legs knocked out from underneath of him, but he gets it in. Dalapaci commits the foul.
Free throw good. Derek Hoare now has 22 points in this contest. Kentucky leads by 41, 73-32.
Certainly a board with a question mark before the season began. I don't think he's a question mark anymore.
Kalapajic may have walked the ball, misses the hook shot. Zizic back up and gets it. The kind of baskets they weren't getting when the game was contested early on. Dicky Beal by one man, kicks it off. Master off the front of the rim. And Dalapaci to the rebound for Yugoslavia. Vilfan. Stripped and out of bounds the ball to Yugoslavia. Vito's led by 1 point very early and haven't seen daylight since then.
You know, lots of times, Fred, when you get involved in a basketball game like this, if you're a coach, you're better off just saying, hey, look, let's go out and play the second half just like a new game. Let's get the first half and go out. Keep the same type of rhythm we've been playing.
Okay, well, make no mistake about it either. Coaches want to win these international games. Jump shot misses. Rebound Kentucky. Dickie Beal takes it off the floor.
Good move.
Oh, Dickie Beal. First 2 points of the night for Dickie Beal, the 5'11 sophomore out of Covington, Kentucky. 75-34 Kentucky. Alapagic, Zizic, moving along the lane. Turpin seals him off to Alapagic. Boy, they just look careless, Yugoslavia, with the basketball. Alapagic one-on-one at the baseline. Just back inside is Zizic. And the shot good.
That's the first time Yugoslavia tonight moved the basketball around and didn't come down and rush up a shot. They actually moved it, made good passes, got good position, took a good shot.
So they looked very slow doing it. But yes, they did. Jim Master tried to lob inside to Turpin, and deflected out of bounds. Charles Burke checks into the lineup. Chuck Verderber is going to sit out. Verderber has been battling a chronic bad back. He's had it since high school. See number 34. Well, it's a strong-looking basketball player. Jim Master. Derek Hort. Not quite. The rebound to Yugoslavia, picked off by Maric. The Vilfan. Vilfan, top of the circle. Long jump shot short. And taken by Petrovic. And a foul called against Kentucky.
He's going to call it on Hort for backing into the player. I thought he did a good job of screening him off. Let's watch it again. There's the foul like right there. It looked like Dalapagic and Maric ran into each other.
A little bit of acting. Dalapagic misses the shot. Rebound chased down by Maric. And it's out of bounds to Kentucky. Maric couldn't control it. 16:49 left in the game. Kentucky leading 75-36. Jim Master gives it back to Dickie Beal. Good look at him bringing it up court.
There's a stack offense inside.
Hort can't find the handle. It's out of bounds. Belongs to Yugoslavia. Again, the Yugoslavians making international rules. Tried to play it in without the official getting a hold of it. There you saw Dalapagic, a little give-up shot. Threw it in back over his head. Dickie Beal, they're 3-on-1. Watch it.
Let's talk about that play in two stages. One, Beal didn't give the ball up too soon up front, which he could have done. You'll see him take the basketball from midcourt. Stay in the middle of the floor so you've got good passing angles both sides. Look at this fake right. Go left. Master gets it. Oh, a little relish on that one.
I think our Popovich said, where did you go? 77-36 Kentucky. Dalapagic is going to be called for charging through an elbow. Kentucky gets the basketball with 16:19 left in the game, leading Yugoslavia 77-36. Into the lineup for Yugoslavia comes Saša Radanović. And Dražen Dalapagic, who may be getting frustrated, a 30-year-old veteran, is going to sit out. 77-36 Kentucky. Dickie Beal, who just made a spectacular play on the 3-on-1 break. To Hurt. Master lobs inside. Turpin goes against Zizic, and we have a walking call against Melvin Turpin.
Fred, I tell you, the thing that I've got to be most impressed about right now with Kentucky, with 16:07 to go in the second half, they're still running their offense. They did not get away from it. They didn't get sloppy. They set their stack offense that time and went inside the Turpin and just committed the turnover.
Baseline, Zizic kicks it back out. Popovich takes the shot off the rim. Turpin had the rebound. Zizic fouling from behind.
And a good position again by Turpin. I tell you, Turpin's played a good basketball game tonight for a young man that I think at the top of the show we discussed maybe it might be one of those problems they may have this year. If Bowie's not able to play, and we may want to get into that conversation a little bit later on in the game and talk about what's happened to Sam Bowie, but Melvin Turpin's played a good ball game tonight.
The best part of his game, maybe, is he hasn't tried to do anything that he can't do. He's gone out and done what he's capable of doing. Hord had a shot pounded back to him and a foul called against Yugoslavia. That one whistled against Jelko Poljak, his second personal foul. That's one of the things that Joby Hall talked to Turpin about more in a moment.
Hord baseline, you're going to go up and see a pretty good block by Poljak. I thought he got a lot of the ball. I didn't think he got much arm. Looked like a pretty good block.
Questionable call right there, but it'll put Charles Gary Hort, rather, on the free throw line, and he nails it. Verderber set to come back in the Kentucky lineup. Hort with 23 points, looking for number 24, gets it. So Hort will sit down, Verderber back in the lineup. Kentucky up by 43 points here. Shot no good. Tip drive Zizic, no good. He has it again. And he's fouled. The basket will count, I believe. Melvin Turpin draws the foul, and I believe Zizic will get the bucket. He will.
Let's give him two strong points on that one. One, he came across the baseline and got a good strong rebound in traffic, then turned around and shot the ball straight up over his head. A good effort that time by Zizic.
Third foul on Turpin. Zizic now has 15 points. And the free throw good. 16 points for Ryko Zizic. He has scored only 15 points the last three games. So he's having himself a good night here tonight. Verderber got it. Chuck Verderber with his first 2 points of the ball game. 81-39, Kentucky. 15-10 left in the basketball game. How many will Kentucky wind up with? Is the question. We have a foul called, I believe, against Zizic, and if so, he's out of the ball game. That's it. Ryko Zizic, the 7-foot center, just fouled out of this basketball game with 16 points and 15:06 left on the night. So Zizic will sit down for the evening. 15:06 left in the game. Kentucky 81, Yugoslavia 39. Melvin Turpin on the free throw line for the University of Kentucky. He has 8 points in the contest. There's Zizic, just fouled out. Free throw good. Turpin 1-for-2 at the line. 71% shooter last year. He's a pretty good free thrower for a big man. Pretty good free thrower for any size. 71%. Turpin good again. He has 10 points. 83-39, Kentucky. Wildcats up by 44. 15 minutes left in the game.
They're up by 44. Fields pressing full court.
Down to baseline, Popovich. Petar Popovich now has a half dozen points. Right back comes Beal to Charles Hurt on the wing. Hurt. Nicky Beal got some penetration. Lets it fly too strong. Rebound contested. We have a foul call on Charles Hurt of Kentucky. His third personal foul. Hurt hasn't had the great night tonight, but he has 10 points. He's been a pretty steady player at a forward for Kentucky. 6'6 junior from Shelbyville, Kentucky.
Here's the carom off the backside. You'll see Hurt come over the back right there of Popovich. He got him on the backside. Beal probably got him second. He grabbed him by the arm as he went by.
A reach along the side of the circle. Lets it fly. Too strong. Hurt has the rebound. He's all tangled up. Kentucky comes away. Nicky Beal. That's scored for Durbin. A little short shot off the baseline. Not quite. Beal fine. Right back for Yugoslavia. Against Nicky Beal. Diophon takes it down the lane, throws up a wild shot that misses. Verderber had it, lost it, and it belonged to Kentucky anyway.
You know, for the point at this juncture of the game right now, you got a guy like Beal and Benefield and Master. And you got big guys like Bowie, and you got Turpin inside like that. You can do a lot of things defensively. You can go out and create some circumstances you might not be able to do if you didn't have those big guys inside. And Beal likes to go out and put pressure on the basketball. He's got that comfort of knowing the big guys back there.
All right, I'm going to guess it. We're going to see the replay again. Well,
there's Hurt with the basketball. He gets it inside. Verderber's trying to reach to get it. He simply got fouled from the backside.
Second foul on Radonovic. And Chuck Verderber nails his third point of the night. I'm going to think very shortly we'll see a lot of the two freshmen, Mike Bellinger and Troy McKinley. Verderber shot good. 4 points for Chuck Verderber. 6'6 senior from Lincoln, Illinois. One of only two seniors on the whole squad. The other one, Bo Landers. Nicky Beal, he flexes it. Master picks it up. Back to Minna Beal against Popovich. Good.
8 points
for Dick Minna Beal.
And again, Fred, it was the defense that got the best.
Kentucky's up by 46. Yugoslavia got no good. Verderber to Minifield. He had Master 2-on-2. He lays it back to Hurt. Back to Minifield. Off the side,
nice
Master. Not quite. They moved the ball very well, though. Yugoslavia Popovich with the basketball. Cross-court pass to Villafan. He lets it fly. Good. Villafan lets it down to his 9 points. There's Kentucky up by 44. When they came up court, I heard a player yell, no, no, no. He wasn't going to force a shot.
Right. I think Joe Hall probably told them that at halftime. Said, now, look, let's go out and play a whole new game. Let's set up and run our stuff the way we've been running it. We don't want to get sloppy. We've got a lot of fans out there. We want to see. Kentucky. Given when Bowie ever comes back to play for this team again, it's going to be nice having Turbin for a backup center.
Oh, boy.
Oh, long jump shot. Bielefond, and Bielefond starting to find the range. He has 11 points. 89-45 Kentucky. Master wide open. Good. How about a shooting clinic right there for Style? 22 points for Jim Master. Out of bounds to Kentucky. The Wildcats force a turnover. Tom Heitz and Derrick Horde now come back onto the floor for Kentucky. Melvin Turpin will sit out. Joby Hall calling a timeout. Jennifer Gerber is going to sit down. 12-21. Left in this basketball game. And here's your score. Kentucky 91, Yugoslavia 45. Here on ESPN, we mentioned it's the first of over 90 games you'll see this winter on ESPN. And we fire it open again Saturday with a doubleheader live. Kansas at North Carolina, 1 p.m. Eastern. And Pittsburgh at Alabama, Birmingham, at night at 9 p.m. Eastern. Saturday, November 28th, college basketball doubleheader at ESPN. Tom Heitz knocks down his 11th point of the night. Kentucky up by 48, 93-45.
That's a pretty nice move by Heitz instead. He turned around and took a short jump hook.
You can tell he's hungry to play, though. He redshirted last year. He's probably having as much fun as anyone tonight. Bielefond, wild shot, misses. Back up for each shot, no good. This time, the shot is good. And that was Polyak that got it down, his fourth point. Jelko Polyak, a 22-year-old of 6'10", gets it. I suppose you're wondering what the Kentucky single-game record is for points. It's 143. They scored that many against Georgia in 1956. Foul called against Yugoslavia. Left in the ballgame. Kentucky with 94 points. They had 94-47. They have the score doubled on Yugoslavia here. There's a double dribble that he got by with. The shot good by Radonovic. Half a dozen points for Petar Radonovic. Just 17 years old. This is Sasha Radonovic. He's 6'9". The Yugos have two 17-year-old players with them on this tour. Master, Gary Cord. Off balance, didn't get it. Rebound knocked out by Polyak, and it's out of bounds and belongs to Kentucky. Polyak could have grabbed it, didn't realize it. Joby Hall, the Kentucky coach.
Yeah, they have a term for the Gerber. Heights, hurt. They call them bangers.
You're right. Brett Barrett, who's redshirted, probably fit that description too. Heights, Ricky Beal. Ford Master. Remember this name, Jim Master. That's one reason. 24 points, Jim Master, just a sophomore. 96-49. Radonovic. Foul called against Tom Heitz of Kentucky. Second foul on Heitz. We'll see it again.
A good defensive ploy. The offensive player gets to the baseline. You see him make that good move. A good defensive player will deny the position low on the block like that, because once you get established, it's awfully tough to stop.
Petrovic misses a shot in the lane. Tom Heitz has the rebound. Up court. Look at Beal's pass. Can Hurt save it? Nope, not quite. Out of bounds. Beal almost got the blind pass to it. Sensational effort by Dickie Beal, and a good effort at the other end by Charles Hurt. They almost connected on a sensational play.
Hey, Beal's not a backup guard for Minifield either.
Kentucky can go to the bench and not get hurt in a few positions. So Gerber gets healthy. He's going to be strong. Either starting or coming off the bench. Beal can replace Minifield. Turpin and Bowie in the middle. pass inside that time. Bielefeld made a nice pass.
Let me ask you a question. How many college basketball teams can go 8-9 deep with that quality of time?
There's only two teams I know in the country that can do that right now, and that's North Carolina and UCLA. They're the only other two clubs I think is capable of going that deep.
I don't say Jim Masters played well, but that's his first foul in this ballgame, too. Free throw, no good, by Poljak. Jelko Poljak, 22 years old. He's 6'10". He's already played in 63 international games. Free throw, good. Poljak has 5 points in the contest. 96-50, Kentucky. Master, lobs. Nice pass to Hurd. Shot didn't quite go, and Hurd up again, and he's fouled. Poljak got it. Good effort underneath by Charles Hurd.
And a great pass by Derek Ford on the baseline. This is good teamwork. You're going to see it right here. Here's the shot right here by Hurd. We're going to see the end of the play right there. How he got that ball was Derek Ford on the other side of the lane making a great pass. There's the foul right there committed by Poljak.
So Charles Hurd at the line, looking for his first point of the second half, his 11th point of the game, and gets it.
Fred, I guess the big date for all the people in Kentucky right now is December the 3rd, when Sam Bowie goes back to the doctor for that x-ray. It'll be the final x-ray to determine whether or not he's going to be able to play this year.
Stress fracture in the shin area of his leg. It'll be 6 weeks from the last x-ray when they do that December 3rd, and needless to say, they'll know a lot more about it then. Bielefeld from downtown. This is Vicky Beal. Oh, this could get exciting. 3-on-2. Beal. Got it. Beal hit the floor hard. He's all right, I think.
When you're handling the fast break, make sure the defensive players are backpedaling. If they're backpedaling, you've got control of the ball.
Standing ovation for Dickie Beal and Rupp Arena. They appreciate the play. Beal fine. 100-50. They're also applauding the century mark here. 100-50 the score. Petrovic misses. Master had the ball, knocked away. Here comes the Beal drive again. 100-50, Kentucky our score.
Nicky Beal under control, takes the basketball. One long step, good lead. He's got the defensive players backing up. Got his legs cut up from underneath him, still got up and got back.
Ike's working, got a chance. Shot blocked in the middle. Bielefeld is fouled, the basket counts.
Good move by Bielefeld that time. He cut across right in front of Beal's body. Beal committed the foul, and he went on, followed through, got the continuation in the basket.
Poljak blocked it.
Right there, good move. Came right across. There's Beal on the arm. He continues through and gets the basket.
Cut it off the block by Jelko Poljak. Minifield wanted traveling, didn't get the call. The free throw no good. Ford had it, picked up by Heights to Dickie Beal. They're 2-on-3. Now they're 3-on-3, and here's Heights. Shot blocked. Picked up by Hort, knocked loose. Bielefeld has it. For Yugoslavia.
Oh, nice move.
Yeah, but you know one difference? It was a nice move. And Bielefeld gets his 15th point. But he wasn't even looking for anyone else coming up with it. And he had a man alongside him.
What's just behind the back right here? A little Maravich. Yes. All right. Good move. Went around behind the back. It was a good move that time. It wasn't a little hot dog either. He had a position for it, took it.
Let me ask you a question. How do you do a 360 with that ball and not travel?
Can't answer that.
Derry Court. Shot off the baseline by Petrovic. 4 points to Trovich. 4 points for the 17-year-old and a timeout taken by Kentucky. 8 minutes and 5 seconds left in this basketball game. And Joby Hall wants to talk to his club. Did he travel? Here, you decide. That's a different play. 8:05, Lukic. There's your score. Kentucky 100, Yugoslavia 56. Back right after this. ESPN takes you live to Washington on Friday, November 27th, 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific for National Hockey League action. Montreal at Washington. New Montreal coach Bob Berry has the Canadiens on top of the Adams division at the moment. Ryan Murray took over the Caps on November 11th. Last year, he was the minor league coach of the year at the Cap Percy Pennsylvania Farm Club. He brought several of his minor league standouts up to try to get the Caps rolling. 8 minutes left in this contest. Kentucky 100, Yugoslavia 56. For a moment there, Kentucky led 100-50. Bo Ladder in the ballgame now for Kentucky. Dickie Beal at the baseline. Joby Hall going a little deeper to the bench. Bo Ladder, one of two seniors. Feeds it inside to Turpin. Turnaround shot, a little short. Ball bangs off the board. Turpin knocked Poljak to the floor and is going to be called for a personal foul. And Poljak gets up holding his leg. Appears to be all right. Melvin Turpin just got rid of it.
Thurman just kind of got Poliak and gave him a little shove, knocked him 6 feet.
Melvin Turpin draws his fourth personal foul of the night. That will put Jelko Poliak, 22-year-old, on the line. He's 6'10", has 5 points in the game. They get six, looking for number seven. 7:42 left in the contest. Kentucky went under Yugoslavia 57. There's the Yugoslav coach, Bogdan Konjovic. 7 point run for Yugoslavia, their biggest in this ball game. It was too little, too late. Out of bounds, the ball to Yugoslavia. Jeff Verderber back in the lineup. Charles Hurt is going to sit down. Jim Masters on the bench. Vicky Beal on the bench. Jerry Cord, Melvin Turpin, Vicky Beal, Bo Lambert. Who am I missing? Verderber on the floor. Verderber with a basketball in the lane. Plays it off. Jerry Cord, Jeffers up. Good.
Verderber could have taken the shot that time, passed it up, and gave it to Horde about 8 feet away from him, and Horde got the good soft jump.
26 points, Jerry Cord. Long poke by Bielefond. Good. Bielefond has 17 points in the second half. 102-59 Kentucky, 7:07 left in this basketball game. Jerry Cord working against Kukulovic. Just came off the bench for Yugoslavia. There's Verderber, shot misses. And a rebound, Poljak. Gets it up to Petrovic. Shot, Sonara, no good. And Sonara, half field, nothing called. Minifield, rather. There's Turpin. It's going to be called for walking. Kurt Minifield back in the ballgame now for Kentucky. Again, Yugoslavia trying to throw it in without the official handling it. That's under international rules. You can do it. NCAA rules, you cannot. The official has to handle the ball.
Kentucky's gone back to their 1-3-1 zone trap right now. Here's Bielefond.
Got no good. Verderber, the lander. He has Turpin up court. He has Minifield in the middle. Try to get it to Turpin. Taken away. And now a foul called against Kentucky. Blocking foul called against Jerry Cord. Tried to get himself set, didn't quite make it.
Bielefond was moving pretty quickly. He got up and down the floor pretty well that time, but Horde never got his position established. And Bielefond got around him, and it was a block. You can see it. See, he didn't give him a chance to move. He was moving his feet.
6:27 left in the ballgame. Kentucky has finally hit a dry spot in this game. They haven't scored for a while. Shot by Bielefond, free throw no good, rebound on the floor, Turpin digs it out for Kentucky, gives them in a field. Up come the Wildcats. Jerry Cord alongside the circle. Slatter trying to save it, and a foul call against Petrovic.
Leonard was getting ready to fall out of bounds with the basketball. Petrovic just gave him a little push trying to help him out.
Dajran Petrovic, the 17-year-old, picks up his third foul right here.
Petrovic just stuck his hand and said, let me help you a little bit.
Sorry, Bo, but I just wanted to see you fall. This is Bo Lander at the free throw line. 6'1 senior. Free throw good from Versailles, Kentucky. There's a Versailles in Kentucky.
Versailles. Versailles in France. Versailles here.
Versailles in Illinois. Bo Lander. Throw good. 104-59 Kentucky. Igor Bielefond for Yugoslavia. Petrovic. Petrovic lets it fly from outside. No good. Chuck Verderber called for a personal foul. Number three on Verderber. He didn't like the call at all.
Let's watch it again one more time. You'll see Verderber commit the foul there, the one he's not too pleased about. I thought he was just going after the basketball that time, and Vukurovic drew the foul.
Vukurovic misses the free throw. And up court, Melvin Turpin clears the rebound to Minifield. Lander, inside, nice feed to Horde, the shot good.
That's good teamwork, Fred. Lander could have taken that shot that time and went inside 6 feet closer to the basket, and Horde got it.
28 points now for Derrick Horde. 106-59 Kentucky. Vukurovic. Bielefond. Kulovic drops it, picks it up, feeds outside. Drobic, baseline. Sonara hits the shot from outside. 6'10 Ivo Sonara getting his fourth point of the night and getting it from the top of the circle. 106-61 Kentucky with 5:20 left in the game.
game.
Then Abiel walks to that court. Both ball clubs have to be tired, Larry.
Oh, yeah, I think so. And they've got some fresh people in there. The only two guys left in the starting group are the Gerber, Horde. Well, they've got Minifield back in the game now, and Turpin.
Turpin may have been fouled. The basket's not going to go. He was fouled.
I think they're going to give him the basket, Fred. It looked like he swiped it out of the rim as it was going down.
They are going to cut it. You're exactly right, Larry Conley. Give Turpin 2 points. He has 14.
This angle, we may not be able to see it from underneath the basket, but you're going to see the Yugoslavian player come across right here. I don't know who that player was. It looked like it was number 12, Juric, the one who swiped that.
That's going to be it for Poljak. Jelko Poljak has become the second Yugoslav to foul the ball game tonight. He'll sit down with a half dozen points. Zizic fouled out earlier. Jelko Poljak sits down, and onto the floor comes Midrag Maric for Yugoslavia. Robin Turpin on the free throw line. 108-61. The scoreboard has Kentucky leading Yugoslavia with 5:05 left. Out. Free throw no good by Melvin Turpin. Yugoslavia having trouble, and Hort coming back. Look at the effort, but Petrovic picks it up for Yugoslavia. Bielefond goes baseline. Shovels it inside. Turnaround shot. No good. Rebound Kentucky. For Gerber. From Minifield. Look at him. Weave in traffic. Right back. Pressure point in the key. Almost threw it away. For Gerber has it. He wants help. Lobs out front to Minifield. Over Petrovic. Good. Kirk Minifield with 10 points. 110-61 Kentucky. Wildcats have led by as many as 50 points in this ballgame. They were hit 100-50. Sonara from long range, no good. Ford follows the rebound. Here comes Minifield.
You know, every time the ball comes off the floor, they're looking for Minifield. Good move to Gerber.
Ladder set up two buckets. That time for Gerber cashed it for his 6 points. 112-61, Kentucky up by 51 points.
Kentucky staying basically with that 1-3-1 zone defense that they presently have.
Shot, no good. Rebound, Sonara hooks it in. Ivo Sonara has a half dozen points.
Coaches will tell you when you start to get tired, there are two things you quit doing. One, you quit playing defense. Two, you quit jumping.
Here come the two freshmen on the floor for Kentucky here. Troy McKinley, number 40, number 5, Mike Bellinger. Derek Ford will sit down. And who else? Charles Hurt coming out of the ball game. The foul was against Maric, his second personal foul. Melvin Turpin, the 6'11 sophomore from here in Western Kentucky, back to the free throw line. He has 14 points here tonight. 71% free throw shooter. Too strong. 71% free throw shooter, I say. That was last year. 112-63 Kentucky. Turpin misses them both. Kentucky with a 49-point lead. Yugoslavia with the basketball. 3:37 left. Petrovic. At the top of the circle, Sonara. He lost it. Minifield's going to pick it up.
Okay,
Minifield leading in the lane. Doesn't get it. Picked by Robert Erber. Shot for Erber. That's his 8 point. 114-63 Kentucky with 3:16 left in the game. Petrovic lobs on the far side. Bielefond from long range. He can pull it up from out there, Larry Collins.
He's got a nest over there. I'll tell you what, he hit about 5 shots from that range.
19 points in the ballgame for Petar Bielefond. 114-65 Kentucky. 3 minutes left in the game. Troy McKinley, Chuck for Gerber, shots up. No good. Rebound taken away. Yugoslavia's Maric. Bielefond pulls up, shoots the jumper, and hits. Bielefond. With 14 points in the second half and 21 in the ballgame now. There's your score. 2:41 left in the contest. I think both sides are kind of worried. Heights set to check back in for Kentucky. So Charles Hurt, ball out of bounds to the baseline, belongs to Kentucky. Tom Heights, Charles Hurt, back into the Kentucky lineup. Chuck Verderber will sit down. Down goes Melvin Turpin, 2:30 left in the game. Turpin sits down with 16 points. Verderber has 8 all in the second half.
Ballinger just can't hit from the corner.
Mike freshman from Jasper, Indiana. 116-67, Kentucky. 2:16 left in this contest. Charles Hurt picks up the deflected pass. The Minifield in the middle. Oh, what a move. Hurt Minifield. Dozen points for Minifield. What a move and what a shot. He just released it softly coming off the spin, Larry. Field five. Facing a Kentucky zone. Petrovic from long range misses. Tip try, no good by Sonara. Here comes Minifield. Might be magic time. Let's watch it. Well, Hikes to Hurt. To Minifield. Hello.
But that was good ball movement this time by Kentucky. They had three or four chances underneath to try to force the shot, and they got it back outside to the guy who really put it home with it.
Minifield. 14 points for Minifield. Kentucky up by 53 points at the moment. Hikes deflects the ball out of bounds. And with 1:28 left in the game, our score, Kentucky 120, Yugoslavia 67. To the left, Minifield can't pick it up. Buffon shoots from the top of the circle, too strong. Personal foul. That's going to be it. And a great
goal. He does a lot of things for this club, and Joby Hall felt like at the end of the year last year, he probably was the premier guard in the country. He played super the last half of their season. Looks like he's going to pick up right where he left off.
I'm not going to say he is, but I'm sure not going to argue with it either. If anybody else is, let him prove it after the night he's had here tonight.
Yeah, there's some great guards in the country this year, but he's certainly be one of the top five or six.
6-6. Free throw good. That's 5 points in the contest. 120-69. A minute left in the ball game. Low ladder, bounce pass. Troy McKinley. The Heights. The ladder. Ladder down the lane. Shot blocked, but a foul called against Miodrag Maric. His third personal foul. Larry, I have to think both coaches. Oh, wait a little.
Foul
was on low ladder. Excuse me. Ladder was called for the personal foul. Makes the foul away from the
rim. It's
hard to say. I think both coaches are going to be happy to see this one come to an end. Been out of hand since midway through the first half. Petrovic gets his first point of the ball game. A 21-year-old. Petrovic set to try it again.
You know, we talked at the top of the show about having some questions answered for this club here tonight. But I think it's raised a bigger question. How good are we? How good a basketball team are we, really?
Low lander. Jumper, top of the circle. Wants two, doesn't get it. Ball's on the floor, and it belongs to Kentucky.
I think maybe they've had some personnel problems alleviated. They found out some things about that, but this maybe is not a good barometer to figure out whether or not they really are this good at basketball.
All those answers will be here by March, won't they? Ballinger. Hello. Ballinger has four. 122-71 Kentucky. 29 seconds left in the game. Sonara lobs cross court. Bielfon gets hurt off his foot. Pulls up, shoots the 10-footer, and gets it.
Nice night by Bielfon. He's had a good basketball game.
23 points on the night. 16 of them in the second half. Ballinger again. What a steamy shoot. 6 points, Ballinger. Traffic, and there's the end of the ball game. It has come to an end mercifully for the Yugoslav national team. The final score here at Rupp Arena in Lexington, Kentucky. Kentucky 124, Yugoslavia 73. Joby Hall shaking hands with the Yugoslav coaching delegation. Just seen his Wildcats take the Yugoslavs apart here, and they did it from very early in the ball game on. Yugoslavia had one slim lead at one point early in the ball game. Then Kentucky hit him with a heck of a run. There's Sam Bouy, the young man on crutches. Again, that leg will be x-rayed again on December 3rd. He's bothered by a stress fracture at the moment. Nobody knows right now when Sam Bouy will return to the Kentucky lineup. And to think they did this tonight without Sam Bowie, even in uniform. Again, our final score, Kentucky 124, Yugoslavia 73. We'll be back right after this.
You know, Lexington, Kentucky, Fred White along with Larry Connolly, we have just seen an outstanding Kentucky team, a deep and talented Kentucky team, just dismantle Yugoslav Nationals 124-73. Derry Cord with 28 points, Jim Master with 24, and Larry Connolly, I dare say the last time a crowd in this arena was shocked this much when Alabama beat Kentucky by 23 in here. I really believe these fans were shocked at what they saw out of this Kentucky ball club tonight.
I think they liked the results of this game a lot better than they did the Alabama game. I think when you stop to analyze this game, and obviously it's over with, they've won by such a whopping score. If you look at it from a comparative score standpoint, the Purdue, Illinois, and Indiana and Rutgers game, you've got to say Kentucky's going to have an awfully good basketball game this year. But again, I've got to get back to this point. I think Yugoslavia was a very tired basketball team. Midway through the first half, when it really got blown open, they seemed to just give up. They didn't want to play anymore. They've got more games this week, and I think possibly they may have been thinking about that. I'm not taking anything away from Kentucky's play. I thought they played exceptionally well, particularly their defense. Give credit to their defense. I think that's what carried them tonight.
We talked about Kentucky being eight or nine people deep, very quality eight or nine people deep, maybe even deeper than that. But we didn't see that much of the freshman tonight. There's some other people that could come off the bench and develop. Sam Bowie wasn't in the lineup here tonight. Maybe won't be in the lineup for some time to come. We don't know about that. But suffice it to say that Kentucky is talented. Kentucky is deep. Kentucky, as everybody thought they would be, will be a major factor again this year in college basketball.
There's no doubt about it, but it's a long way from November to March, and we've got a long march to the Superdome down in New Orleans. And I think you're going to see a lot of good college basketball teams, and I think, like you, that Kentucky's going to be one of them.
A lot of college basketball you'll see here on ESPN, the first of over 90 games you'll see here on ESPN this year. What a start here tonight. Kentucky got them rolling. They have down Yugoslavia.
And they are yielding 107.8. The Cavaliers, when they are finished tonight, will be heading back to Cleveland and will be at the Coliseum for two games, Tuesday night against the Philadelphia 76ers and Thursday night against the Phoenix Suns. Then the Cavs go right back out on the road, and 1 week from tonight, we'll be chatting with you from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And that will be the start of a three-game trip that will take us from Milwaukee to Washington to New Jersey. Looking at the Lakers, since we saw them, they have just made one basic change, and that was a big trade that brought them the very valuable services of forward center Michael Thompson. Thompson had been playing down in San Antonio. He had, of course, come from Portland in an earlier deal. Thompson, really, a lot of people feel, has added that last little touch to a setup that will take the Los Angeles Lakers to the NBA title this year. It remains to be seen if that, in fact, is what will happen, but certainly in theory, it holds up well. They sent Frank Murkowski to the San Antonio Spurs, and also Peter Gudmundsson, but Gudmundsson has a bad back problem, has surgery, and will not be available to them until next year. The rest of the cast remains the same. They have some rookies. Adrian Branch, who was drafted by the Bulls last year in the second round, is with them this year. Also, Billy Thompson, their first-round draft choice from Louisville, sees some duty. They picked up a free agent in Wes Matthews, a guard out of Wisconsin, has bounced around the league last year with San Antonio. This is his seventh year in the league. The rest of the guys are the basic crew that has made the Lakers what they are today. One heck of a basketball team. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Michael Cooper, A.C. Green, Magic Johnson, Kurt Rambis, Byron Scott, and James Worthy. And one other man to mention, another free agent pickup, Mike Schmeich, picked up a seven-footer in his second year, played last year with the Chicago Bulls. We are located here in the Forum, just below the approach path to LAX. In fact, last night when we were flying in, I realized that I had a better vantage point for the ball game from the airplane than I do here in the broadcast booth. But be that as it may, we'll weather the storm and to give you the word's eye picture of tonight's ball game, hopefully the Cavaliers. And Lenny Wilkins, if you heard him on the pregame show, feels the Cavaliers will tonight come back and respond against one of the best, if not the best team in the NBA, after, of course, doing less than that of the ball game against a much lesser opponent in Phoenix on Thursday night. The other games of the NBA tonight, the L.A. Clippers at New York, New Jersey at Philly, Utah at Atlanta, Milwaukee at Indiana. Those should all be done by now. We'll be getting the scores shortly. Also, Sacramento with Phoenix and Houston and Seattle. Willie Erskine stopped by to say hi. Used to work for the Cleveland Electric Company. He's now out here on the West Coast. Wanted to say hi to his mom and dad. Steve Jackson, living in Newport Beach, which I would like to say hi to his family and friends back in Cleveland and in Mansfield, from whence he originally comes. And an interesting note here says that June Thomas just had her gallbladder out 2 weeks ago, and her sons Scott and Brad want to be remembered to her. June, if you're within the range of my voice, I extend my best wishes to you. However, the note is addressed to Chick, and I think they may have hit the wrong broadcast position here, but our sympathies go out to June and her bad gallbladder, no matter where she happens to be. And if it is